topic. With that topic, we will with that information, we will take, we will gather some more information. Such type of data is said to be secondary data. Okay. Now, data may that maybe we can prepare a frequency distribution table for grouped data and ungrouped data. Ungrouped data is nothing but that. Whatever data they are giving, directly we will prepare the frequency distribution table. Frequency distribution table is nothing but whatever frequency count of objects we are representing using a table by using the tally marks is known as frequency distribution table. And if we are using ungrouped data, so directly whatever information they are given, directly we will prepare. And if that data is less, then only we can able to prepare directly frequency distribution table. But some cases observations will be more. In that case, we need to divide the data into some groups. Those groups are said to be class intervals. And for that grouped data, we will prepare a frequency distribution table. So for that, we will see two examples now. First one. Make a frequency distribution. Make a frequency distribution of the following series. And here that series is given like this: 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times repeated. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 6, 7, 7. So this is the given information. And here, what is the range of the data? We will see. Highest observation is 7 and lowest observation is 1. 7 means 1 to 7. It is easy to represent in a table. Means directly for ungrouped data, directly we are using the data to prepare the frequency distribution table, and it is the primary data. Whatever they are given information, we are using. Okay. Now observe how we are preparing the frequency distribution table. First, observation. Whatever observation we are getting, observation and tally marks. So that frequency represented by tally marks. And frequency is nothing but how many times it is occurring. So that is frequency of that observation. Okay. Now observe the first value. First observation, 1. So 1 to 7 only all the observations. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So directly we are preparing the frequency distribution table without grouping the intervals. So that's why it is a frequency distribution table showing for ungrouped data. Now observe the each observation, the type of observation, how many times came. That is frequency of that observation we will check. One, only once came, so frequency is 1. And two times came, so 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times came, 3. And 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times came. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times came. And 6, 1, 2, 3, 4 times came. 7 is twice. That's all. Now represent by using the tally marks. By using the tally marks, how we are writing 1? Just 1. Okay. And for 2, 1, 2 lines we will use. For 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. With the fifth line, we must cross the first four lines. Okay. So this is 5. Now 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Next 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 1, 2. That's all. So like this, we are representing the given data by using the frequency distribution table. Okay. So because here directly we are using, so it is ungrouped data. For ungrouped data, we are prepared a frequency distribution table. Okay. Now coming to the next example. Construct a frequency distribution table for the following data. Construct a frequency distribution for the following series of numbers. For the following data. So here, whatever they are given, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 11, 12, 12, 13, 13, 13, 14, 14, 14. 15, 16, 17, 18, 18, 19, 20, 20, 21, 22, 24, 24, 25. So like this, they are given the data and asking us to prepare the frequency distribution table. So what is the least value here? 2, and highest value is 25. So 2 to 25 numbers to write is very lengthy table we'll get. For that sake, we will classify the given data into some groups. That is nothing but we will divide the given data into some class intervals. Means after changing it into grouped data, we will prepare a frequency distribution table. Okay. So for that sake, how we have to change? Normally, we have to take total number of class intervals in between 5 to 8, 5, 6, 7 or 8. Okay. Here, least value. What is the range of the data? First, find out. Depending on the range, we can decide how many class intervals are enough to take. So, range of the data means range is equal to highest value is 25, least value is 2. 25 minus 2 is 23. So, if we are going through 4 numbers, means if we want to use 6 class intervals, 23 by 6, very smaller numbers, only 3 class intervals will get. 23 by 6, 6 fours are 64, 24 will get. So go through with 5, maybe we'll get 4 numbers, more than 4 means 5 we will get nearly, 5 class intervals we'll get. So we will see what are those class intervals. So range of the data is 23. I want to take 23 by 5, means 5 class intervals I want to take. So 5 fours are 20, means approximately 4 observations I need to count. Okay, that means class intervals. First number was a 2, but what I am using? 1, 2, 5. Okay, then 6 to 10. Okay, 11 to 12, inclusive classes I am using. Sorry, 11 to 15, 16 to 20, 21 to 25. That's it. 25 is our highest value. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 class intervals. Nearly we got 5 class intervals. Okay, just observe class length. 5 minus 1, 4, 10 minus 6, 4. 15 minus 11, 4, 20 minus 16, 4, 25 minus 21, also 4. That is the class length. Okay. Now, these are the class intervals. Means we have changed into some groups. For this, we need to take frequency distribution table. So, tally marks and how many numbers are came. Frequency, how many numbers are came in those intervals. First, identify the range of the class, range of the data. After getting that, try to take number of class intervals, at least 5 or 6, 7 or 8 from this group only. So if I am taking 5, then for every 4 numbers, if I am dividing the class interval, so that I am covering every number in this range. So I got 5 class intervals with the class length 4. Okay, class length is nothing but difference between upper limit and lower limit of particular class. For every class, it will be remains the same. Now, 1 to 5, how many numbers are there? That is frequency of this class interval. How many observations are there? We will see. 2, 3, 4. All these are between 1 to 5 only. So, 1, 2, 3 numbers are there. Frequency is 3. Next, 6 to 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 numbers are there. And 11 to 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next, 16 to 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the last class interval. Okay, inclusive class intervals I have used means that number belongs to that particular class only. Both lower limit and upper limit belongs to that class interval only. Okay. Now, draw the tally marks. 1, 2, 3. Now 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's all. So just observe, in the previous question, we have prepared the frequency distribution for ungrouped data. Now here, after grouping the data, we are preparing the frequency distribution table because it is somewhat larger data. Okay. And now just observe by which data we can rewrite the information again. See, for first question, directly we have drawn the frequency distribution table. Means, if first suppose three numbers are there between them, means what are the, means here if the observation is one that is repeated three times, that means we can able to write 1, 1, 1. Means we can rewrite the given data from the first type of ungrouped data from the frequency distribution. Sharing data like this. Now 1 to 5, three numbers are belongs to this class interval we know. But which are those three observations we don't know. Means 2, 3, 4 only is occurring between those class intervals we can't able to write. So for ungrouped data, we can rewrite the data again after the constructing the frequency distribution table also. For a grouped data, we can't able to write the question again. Okay. Now observe the third question depending on this. What are the differences between the above two frequency distribution tables asked? First one we prepared for ungrouped data and second one we prepared for grouped data. And that is very simple data and it is somewhat larger data. Okay. And next, from which of the frequency distributions we can write the raw data again? Means whatever question is given, that one how, from which table we can able to write again? For this table we can't able to write. Whereas for first question, we can write the given question again. Okay. Now coming to the next example. The following marks achieved by 30 candidates. In mathematics of SSC. examination held in So what are those marks? Just observe 45, 46 per 30 students given. Sorry, 56. 84 76 79 40 54 68 69 60 59. Construct the frequency distribution table with the class intervals. Failed 0 to 34. Third class. Thirty-five to 49. Second class. 50 to 59. Next, first class. 60 to 74. Next, distinction. Distinction 75 to 100. So here in this question, just observe, this is the given information. Marks of 30 students given, and those marks from 0 to 100. Okay, because they only given the class intervals 0 to 34 35 to 49 50 to 59 60 to 74 75 to 100. Observe the class intervals 0 to 34 35 to 49, means inclusive classes given. Okay, for this data we need to prepare a frequency distribution table. Very simple, already they only given class intervals. Just think how count how many observations are there the particular class and prepare the frequency distribution table. That's all, very simple. Okay, so first class interval. That is marks for this question. Marks and tally marks, and third column frequency. Frequency is nothing but number of students, number of candidates who got between that class interval. We must find frequency, means number of candidates or number of students. So here 5 class intervals are given. First one is 0 to 34, next 35 to 49, next 50 to 59, 60 to 74, 75 to 100. So these are the five class intervals given in the question itself. For these class intervals, we need to prepare the frequency distribution table. So now count how many students got between 0 to 34. 0 to 34. So 30, we will check. Ala 35, 35 is there. 1, 3, 13, 29. 1, 2, 3. 3 people got between 0 to 34. Next, 35 to 49. 35 is there. 1, 49 also. 35 to 49. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 people are there. Next, 50 to 59. 50 also we must consider. 59, till 59. All are 50s only. So 56. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, 60 to 74. 60 and 70. Till 74 we must check. It is 75. 68. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 75 to 100, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 students are there. So whether we got 30 or not, total 30 candidates, observe the number of students, how many are there? 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 11, 21, 21 plus 9, 30. So 30 students are covered. Now, no observation is missing. So if you don't want to face such type of difficulties, arrange the given data in ascending order or descending order. Then you will write, you can able to write easily. Okay. Now coming to the tally marks. So 3, 1, 2, 3, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay? So for these class intervals, the class length is not equal. Okay? Remember that. Now coming to the next example. A grouped frequency distribution table. A grouped frequency distribution table. Is given below with class marks. Class marks are nothing but mid values of the class intervals. Mid values of class intervals. And the frequencies the table is given. They are asking to find class intervals. Find the class intervals. So here table is class marks and frequencies. Horizontal table given. Seven, five. 15, 23, 31, 39, 47. And here the frequencies are 5, 11, 19, then 21, 12, 6. So like this given table, which is showing class marks of particular class intervals and the frequencies of that class interval. Now, what is the class interval? We don't know. First, suppose we have the class interval 1 to 5. First, suppose one of the class interval 1 to 5. What is its class mark we want to find? Class mark is nothing but average of class limits. Okay, lower limit plus upper limit by 2. That is 1 plus 5, 6 by 2. 6 by 2 is nothing but 3. 3 is the mid value of this class interval. Means class mark of 1 to 5 is 3. Here this value is given, class marks are given. We need to find out this value. How we can able to find? See, further check. First of all, whether the class length is same or not. Means difference between two class marks is same or not. We will check. See, whatever difference we are getting between upper limit and lower limit. Means what is the class length? That one only will get the difference between two class marks. Just see, 5 minus 1, 4 will get. For suppose next class interval is 6 to 10. So here mid value, how we are getting 6 plus 10 by 2, that is 16 by 2, nothing but 8. What is the length, class length? 3 plus 5, 8, 1, 2, 5, 5. Okay. So 1 to 5 and 5 to 10. In such type of cases, we will get equally. Just observe. 1 to 5 means we will get mid value 3. And 5 to 10, 15 by 2, 3.7.5 will get. So now coming to this question, here class marks are given. What are those classes? We don't know. Before that, what is the difference between two class marks? We will see. See, 15 minus 7, 8. Now compare these two class marks. 23 minus 15, 8. Find out this difference. 31 minus 23 also 8. 39 minus 31 also 8. 47 minus 39 also 8. This difference between the class marks always equal, and it is represented by H. So difference between class marks. Successive class marks. That is equal to 15 minus 7, which is nothing but 8. And it is same for remaining successive classes also. For every class, we got 8 only. And H by 2, half of H, how much we will get? 8 by 2, which is nothing but 4. 2 ones are 2 fours. We will get the limits by, lower limit is by taking x minus h by 2. X is nothing but class mark. Always class marks are denoted by x. Frequencies are denoted by f. X minus h by 2 will get lower limit. And upper limit of the class will get by x plus h by 2. Okay. So for first class, x minus h by 2. X value is for first class is 7. Minus h by 2 is 4. So 7 minus 4 is nothing but 3. And upper limit of that class is 7 plus 4, which is nothing but 11. Means first class interval is 3 to 11. For second class, x is 15. And 15 minus 4 equal to 11. 15 plus 4 is equal to 19. So 19. So 11 to 19. Just observe 3 to 11. Difference is 8 only. 11 to 19, difference is 8 only. Next value will be 19 plus 8. That is 27. Okay, so like that you'll get the class intervals. Till how many frequencies are there? How many class marks are there? Class marks given? Those many class intervals we'll get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 class intervals we'll get. Okay. So H is nothing but difference between two successive class marks, and it is equal difference between two successive class marks. Therefore, H is equal to 15 minus 7, which is nothing but 8. 15 minus 7, which is nothing but 8. H by 2 is equal to 8 by 2, which is nothing but 4. And lower limits of particular class is given by lower limit is equal to x minus h by 2 when mid class marks are given. And upper limit will be equal to x plus h by 2. So that we will get the class intervals. Class marks, first we'll write class marks. X values and class intervals we need to find, and then for that class interval what is the frequency. So lower limits or upper limits. Once you got first two class intervals, it is very easy to write the remaining class intervals. 1, 5, 6 will do it. So first class mark is given 7, 15, 23, 31, 39, and 47. And frequencies are 5, 11, 19, 21, 12, 6. Now class intervals. Lower limit is given by x minus h by 2. X value is 7 for this first class. Okay. So 7 minus 4 is equal to, so first class is 7 minus 4 to 7 plus 4. That is equal to 3 to 11, first class interval. Second class interval is 15 minus 4 to 15 plus 4. That is 11 to 19. Third class interval is 23 minus 4 to 23 plus 4. That is 23 minus 4 is 19. 23 plus 4 is 27. That's what I told you. Once you got these first two class intervals, 3 to 11, 8 difference. 11 to 19, 8 difference. And 19 is continued. 19 plus 8 is 27. So similarly, next values will get by. 27 is the lower limit of the fourth class. And higher limit is 27 plus 8. That is 35. Next, 35 plus 8, 43. 43 plus 8, 51. These are the class limits. Okay, class intervals. Okay, so when class marks are given, this is the way to write the class intervals. So remember these formulas. Okay, once observe this here, difference between two class marks, so that is 15 minus 7 is 8, and difference between two limits, 11 minus 3 also 8. Class size and difference between two class marks is same, just observe. See, mid value is 7 given for first class interval, whether it is correct or not, for whatever values we got observed. 11 plus 3, 14, 14 by 2 is equal to 7, average of lower limit and upper limit is 7, and 11 plus 19 is 30, 30 by 2 is 15. Okay, now coming to the next topic, cumulative frequency. So with the example, we'll see what is meant by cumulative frequency. Okay. Here we have two types of cumulative frequencies. That one also we will see. Just observe it. 10 to 30, 20 to 30. Now just observe, all these are inclusive classes only. Means observe the upper limit of the first class and lower limit of the second class, both are equal, so exclusive classes. For the exclusive class intervals, class boundaries and class limits both are same. So for this, no need to write again class boundaries. Okay, both are same. Now here frequency given 60, 120, 300, 360, 50, 25, 10, 5. Here total number of candidates are 1000. Add all this compulsory, you'll get 1000. So here my question is, now observe this lower boundary of these class intervals. See, 90 is lower boundary of this last class. From last class I'm taking. Just observe how many people are getting more than 90 marks is 5. Number of students who are getting more than 90 marks is 5. Number of students who are getting more than 80 marks means 90 and 80 to 100 marks we need to take count. Means 10 plus 5, totally 15. How many people are getting more than 70 marks? 25 plus 10 plus 5, that is 15 plus 25. Okay, 40 students. Means to get more, who got more than that lower boundary? Number of students, frequency, some of the candidates, number of candidates, how we are getting? By adding all those numbers. To get more than 80 people, lower boundary of this particular class, two classes are including 10 plus 5. Frequency of these two classes is 10 and 5. So when you are taking more than, means greater than value, all the frequencies we are adding, sum of frequencies is called cumulative frequencies. If you are starting adding from last class and considering the lower boundary of particular class, is known as greater than cumulative frequency. Adding the frequencies is cumulative frequency. Two types of frequencies are there, greater than cumulative frequency and less than cumulative frequency. Greater than cumulative frequency is tells us how many people got more number of more marks according to that whatever boundary is given. See, for suppose 50 to 60, I want to find out how many people got more than 50 marks. So by constructing GCF, directly we can able to say how many people are there till that. If you are not constructing that, you need to repeat the process. That means 360 plus 50 plus 25 plus 10 plus 5, you must do. Some of those frequencies is cumulative frequency. Okay. And less than cumulative frequency, instead of this last class, we will